It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. I'm so glad you stayed. I've got two talented individuals on the couch to introduce you to. And I can tell you the first one is a torchbearer of local tradition. KZN's finest composer, Duduzo Makatini, is a true virtuoso. His particular artistry on the piano articulates an African spiritual journey, and today he's ready to transport us with him. And I can tell you that this sneak peek will give you an idea of where we're going to go. See, there's something about jazz that's emotive, it's passionate, there's something beautiful about it. So a massive welcome to Duduzo, as well as you, Malusi, to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Man, I was already transported from a clip. That was like 15 seconds. It was so great. I'd love to know a bit more about this particular journey. You know, you're doing an event now, but I think let's start with you. Yeah. But because you're an improviser, you're multi-award winning, you're a healer, you're a scholar, you're a musician, you're everything, basically.
Well, thank you. Well, I think there's a sense in which all of these are connected. And I think my artistry builds from making these connections,
yeah,
and making them a bit more explicit.
Yeah.
So part of my journey growing up was that music had a particular function, whether it was in a village or whether it was during a particular ritual ceremony. So this is something that I wanted to keep as a connection,
yeah,
even throughout my journey. So when I went to study music formally, I realized that there was a disconnect with regards to the importance of spirituality, importance of a way of being as part of where the sound articulates. Later on in my life, when I could decide,
yes,
I brought all of those aspects back and tried to create a kind of vocality of what it would mean to be in a post-colonial South Africa while having most of our cultures erased, well, for many years, starting with slave trade all the way to settler colonialism, yeah, and to this moment. And what are some of the things that have really refused this erasure? And that's really what informs my practice. It's looking at pre-colonial thoughts about cosmology, ways of being in the world, ways of seeing, ways of imagining, and bringing that memory as an important hinge that sort of informs how we move forward. And of course, jazz is always regarded as a thing that comes from outside.
Yes.
So my thing is like, there is a very specific articulation of it that comes from inside. So it's all of these kind of like questioning that produce more questions and more questions. And I think the journey goes on.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was really, really beautifully articulated, because I was transported once again just listening to the way you've unpacked that, I think it's important. What you've said is that we are taking history, and we know it's hurtful, we know it's painful.
Yeah.
But hurt and pain, those are the catalysts for solution creation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Building bridges between people, understanding.
Yeah. Yep.
The type of thing that you almost shun because you want to run away from a hurtful past.
Yep, definitely.
But you need to use it to fuel the future.
You got it.
And I think jazz is the vehicle.
Precisely, man. Precisely.
Man, that's beautiful, actually.
Thank you.
Malusi, I know you are the events guy. Jazz and Vines is your thing. And this particular event is, you know, singing as a way of being in the world. What was it about Duduzo that really said to you, you know, this is going to be an event that's going to be so special?
Well, you know, with Duduzo, it speaks for itself, really.
Yeah.
Of who he is in terms of if not one of the most prominent living artists in the world, really. So when we thought of Jazz and Vines, I mean, it came out of a void, really, because of COVID-19
yes.
and performing artists not having a platform. But also, it was both from frustration and love. Frustration that we have nowhere to go in the winelands. And and then of course the love for jazz and sort of the laziness to drive to Cape Town. So
yes, man.
So when we thought hard and then said, look, spoke to the friends at Glen Ellie Estate, Nick and Luke, and we said, look, guys, listen, can you open up your cellar? We want to do something amazing. And Duduzo was gracious enough, really, to sort of agree and then took the creative direction in really what he wants to do with the three rituals. So it came out of quite a very simplistic idea, you know, and we decided, listen, you know what? Let's do it in our whole background in the winelands because, I mean, there are very few and far between events of this nature. So that's what we decided to do.
You know what I like about both of you? There's a constant narrative. COVID has been a hurtful experience to most, and out of that comes this event
sure.
that brings prosperity.
Sure.
You were chatting about our history yep. and how some cultures were erased,
yep.
but now you're bringing it back.
Yep.
Do you feel what you guys are generating in terms of energy here? And that is this beautiful rebirth yep. and resurrection. So that's what I feel. No, I'm serious, I'm feeling this. You've got me all spiritual right now, I won't lie to you, but you will feel the same way a little bit later as this incredible talent, Duduzo, will be entertaining you on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And of course, so just a little bit, a little detail to you, Friday 11th to Sunday 13 March 2022, Glen Ellie Estate in Stellenbosch, you can go and check it out, singing as a way of being in the world. And trust me, these two will be in your world on your Feel Good Breakfast Show a little bit later.